My name is Ludo Lefebvre. I always want to know what really my true ancestor was. And voilà, 23andMe came as a sponsor on my TV show.
So excited to do that.
It's so easy. Get the 23andMe kit, open it, spell in the tube, shake it, close it, put back in the box, mail it, and a few weeks after, you get the result. The report came. I was thinking I was 100% French. Guess what?
Oh putain.
I'm not.
I'm an imposter. Wow, that's crazy.
I am French, but not just French. I'm a little bit of a British. Long be to the Queen. Belgium. That's heavy. A little bit of Italian. Chef Ludo.
German.
I'm going to say about German. Are you good? Yeah, I'm a German Shepherd.
So,
this season on Ludo à la Maison, we are going to explore the different dishes from my DNA. It's going to be fun. But don't forget, I'm French.
Bon, alors aujourd'hui, j'ai une grosse surprise. Today, I have a big surprise for the show. Today, we have my wife, Chrissy, who is with me on the show.
No, it's a
welcome.
First.
Hi, ça va?
Ça va, thank you. It's so
you're
nice.
Good?
Thank you for having me.
Bon, what are we going to do, Chef Chrissy?
Well, we're going to discover my German heritage, because my 23andMe results showed that I was 53%.
53? That's a lot.
German,
I'm
yeah.
Half. She's born in Germany. So where today for Chrissy, I decided to do a
pork schnitzel.
Schnitzel. I can say it.
Schnitzel.
And it's hard. We did the pork schnitzel with a little mushroom sauce. So we're going to do some onions. Okay. Put a little bit of oil on your
what kind of oil? Grapeseed?
Grapeseed oil.
Okay. What do I put it on? Medium?
Yeah. Do you have any dish you like from Germany?
I love pretzels.
Oh, so strong, these onions.
I love the German pretzels.
I don't like a pretzel.
I know, it's emotional for me too.
Right. When you're married and kids and job, it's hard to spend time together in the kitchen. It's hard. So yeah, today I was pretty, great to be Chris in the kitchen. In the meantime, I'm gonna take some butter mushroom. Do you like mushroom?
Okay.
Okay, Chef Chrissy. So butter mushroom. Okay, if you don't have any butter mushroom, you can always use a substitution. So voilà. So we're gonna caramelize that. So let's caramelize that. Okay. Tout petit peu de rosemary. So you don't really, I know your dad was a little bit of German.
Yeah.
Right?
My dad
so,
is
but
German,
did you
yes.
Really eat German food before in your house or whatever? No, not really.
No, we didn't really eat German. I mean, I feel very German because we were always told we were so German growing up. So I wasn't surprised by my reports at all. It's good to know that it reinforced what my family has always told
true.
Me.
True. Take the kids, you know, over there.
I want to go, for sure.
Germany. Now we're going to take our pork, chopped meat, we're going to put it like that, and we're going to pound a little bit. Okay?
Do you want to pound it with this?
Yeah. No, it's a little bit gentle. So, we take the pork, we're going to pound a little bit the pork, make sure it's even everywhere, okay? No, but also, you know, like in a...
Is that your gentle pound?
Huh?
That's a gentle pound?
Yeah.
Doesn't seem so gentle.
Because the pot is very heavy, you know?
The pot is very heavy.
Very heavy, seriously. It's like... Okay, bon, caramelized, it's good like Chrissy, là?
I think so.
So now we're going to deglaze with some white wine.
Okay.
Yeah. Voilà. Let boiling like for a good 2 minutes. Like this, you burn a little bit the alcohol. Like this, in the sauce, you can have the taste of the white wine, but not too much alcohol. Beef stock, mix, and bring to boil.
Do I cover it?
No, I leave it like that.
Okay.
Crack 4 eggs. Ready? Sour cream. And now you're going to beat. Gentle, gentle. So here you have some little mace. That's the skin of the nutmeg.
Okay.
So you can smell, you know, you can really smell like
and
nutmeg.
It smells so good.
Huh?
It smells
yeah.
So good.
You know? Voilà, so put the mace here. And now you're going to beat it, yeah. Ready? So nutmeg,
mace.
Mace, good job, Chrissy.
Okay.
And now we're going to put a little bit of nutmeg. Take
yeah. Them. Oh, you want me to do it?
Yeah. Okay. You say you know nothing. So. Vas-y. Check it. Bon.
So, ça va.
How much do I do?
Oh, yeah. Good. Voilà. Okay, I'm going to put now some parmesan here.
In the breadcrumbs?
Yeah, as the breadcrumbs, okay. Mix that very well. So that's the breading.
Okay.
It's like when we do fried chicken, okay?
Okay.
It's
dry.
Dry. Wet.
Dry.
Voilà. Mother, that you, when you do the fried chicken?
Yeah.
We did that.
Yeah, a lot of fried chicken.
A bit of fried chicken.
Nuremberg days.
Yeah. Alors, non-stick skillet.
It's a non-stick. I didn't even realize it was non-stick.
It's non-stick, yeah. Yeah. It's a non-stick. You know why we use crepes at all?
Because it has a high burn temperature.
Voilà. Très bien.
I think I don't pay attention to this stuff.
No, I know.
I've learned a lot from you watching you.
So you want to start the oil to make sure it's hot enough? Hot
okay.
enough?
It's always the problem. I can never figure out the oil temperature.
So it's better to be a little bit more hot and after low the temperature than just be not hot enough. And after, because it's not hot enough, all the bread is going to soak the fat. It makes sense what I'm saying, guys? Translate in German.
Nine.
But you know what I mean? Like if the oil is too low temperature.
Yeah, then the breading absorbs it
exactly.
And then it just becomes
exactly. Mushy. Yeah. Thank you for translating.
I'm here. He's walking subtitles.
Okay, so. Voilà, see? You know it's hot when you hear a little bit of sizzling.
Mm-hmm.
Off you go there. We'll give a nice coloration to our pork schnitzel. Okay?
So voilà. You say schnitzel.
Well, it's about now. We're going to cook the schnitzel 50-50 both sides.
Okay.
So we should do that more for the kid.
We should.
You know, so I'm sure kid will love it. It's like the restaurant.
Well, they just came home from school. We can have them taste it.
That's right. I'm sure Luca will love this thing.
You're going to taste my schnitzel, Luca? Okay.
Voilà. So you see? You see? Yeah. I show the oil go over there. Like that. Not heavy. I do a pork schnitzel. Oh! Oh la vache!
You know where this is from? This dish?
You know where from? Where's mom is from? Where's mom is from?
Where's mommy from?
Normally. I mean, we know she's from Colorado, but...
What country do you wear an international day at school?
Germany.
Yeah!
Yeah!
And you know where Papa's really from?
Mm-mm.
England.
Oh, don't
say that.
Mama! Mommy, mommy, mommy! Oh, oh, oh. Papi's from England. The cream paper is from England. Great. Luca, don't tell nobody.
It's a secret, Luca. I love you.
Voilà. Hop. Like this. I'm gonna put my pork schnitzel here. That's how you want it. This one. Voilà. Okay. Un peu de sel. Voilà. Mais un petit peu de lemon zest. Here's a macro plank. Voilà. So, you know, some mushroom.
German food. You're ready, Luca?
Don Pellegrino? Mm-hmm. Luca's gonna like it?
Yeah, of course he's gonna like
it. So?
Mm-hmm. Schnitzel is a good dish. It's easy to do. It's good. Put good sauce with that or just with mustard. You know, it's just good. Everything pan fried like that is good.
It's good, isn't it?
That's good, huh?
Yeah, so are you officially German?
When you don't like it, it does the truth.
Should we add it to our rotation for dinner?
Yeah.
Yeah? A little German food for the family? I mean, clearly he likes it.
No, thank you for coming.
Thank you for having me.
Merci. Well, voilà. It was our pork schnitzel with our mushroom sauce and...
a little beer for Oktoberfest.
Voilà.
It's not October.
Yes. Luca, it's the magic of television.
Yeah.